Now let's discuss about the theory of this frequency modulation. That means let's obtain a mathematical expression to represent the wave in a frequency modulation or the representation of the frequency modulated wave. Usually it is not a sine wave. Sine wave has a particular frequency, but a frequency modulated wave have a varying frequency. So now let's represent it. You know that the amplitude of the carrier is kept constant, but the frequency fc of the carrier is varied by the modulating signal. That is what happens in a frequency modulation. The frequency carrier frequency fc actually varies at the rate of the signal frequency fs. That we have shown, the variation in the carrier frequency occurs at the same frequency as that of the signal frequency, but the variation, the amount of variation, is actually determined by the amplitude of the signal. Now we have seen that the maximum frequency deviation, that is frequency of the FM wave, varies about the center frequency FC, and here we will have some FC max, the maximum frequency which corresponds to the maximum amplitude of the modulating signal, and FC corresponding to the zero amplitude of the modulating signal, and it has a minimum frequency FC minimum, which occurs at the negative maximum of the signal amplitude. So now if we calculate the change in the frequency delta F, so this is the change in frequency, that is delta F, or this will be the same delta F itself, that is the change in the frequency of the modulating signal is maximum at, or the maximum value of the change in the frequency is FC max minus FC, or it will be same as FC minus FC minimum. So this value, either this FC max minus or FC, or FC minus FC minimum, will give the maximum variations in the frequency of the carrier wave in a frequency modulated wave. Now suppose we modulate a 100 megahertz carrier wave by a signal modulating signal wave, or by a signal wave with a 1 volt amplitude and let's say 1 kilohertz frequency. And when we modulate a carrier wave of 100 megahertz with a signal wave of 1 volt 1 kilohertz, then suppose maximum frequency deviation, frequency deviation is let's say 25 kilohertz. That is, when the signal amplitude is plus 1 volt, the carrier frequency has been changed to 100 plus megahertz plus 25 kilohertz, or which is equal to 100.025 megahertz. And when the signal voltage is minus 1 volt, that is negative amplitude of the signal voltage is negative maximum, then the carrier frequency has been changed to 100 megahertz minus 25 kilohertz, which is equal to 100 minus 0.025 megahertz. I am representing it like this. Here it is 100 plus 0.025, if we are representing it like this. And this will repeat or the at a rate of 1000 cycles per second, because the frequency of the signal is 1 kilohertz. That means this 100 plus 0.025 megahertz frequency occurs 1000 cycles in a second. So that's what meant by modulating a particular free wire with a particular signal wave. Here the amplitude of these modulated waves with a frequency variation having 100 plus 0.025 megahertz and 100 minus 0.025 megahertz is same as that of the amplitude of this carrier wave. Now, suppose the modulating sine wave, modulating wave is a sine wave, and the carrier wave is also sine wave, with a carrier wave with a very high frequency and modulating wave is a low frequency. So suppose we are having a modulating signal represented by ES is equal to ES cos omega s into t, where ES is the amplitude of the modulating signal. In this example, 1 volt is the ES, and the cos omega st, where omega s is the angular velocity of the signal, which is 2 pi fs, where fs is the frequency of the signal, which is here it is, in this example it is 1 kilohertz. Now, this signal is used to modulate a carrier wave of frequency, let's say FC. Now, the frequency modulated wave will have a variation about this frequency FC, and that variation is actually proportional to the modulating signal ES. Let's say the frequency, the carrier frequency FC is changed to FC plus or minus KES by modulating it with a signal of amplitude or signal represented by ES. That means the change in carrier frequency is KES due to the modulating signal, where K is called a frequency deviation constant. So what I have done here is that we are having a carrier wave with frequency fc, and we are having a signal with a voltage represented by es, which is the instantaneous value. Now if they are frequency modulated, if these two signals are frequency modulated, then the frequency fc will be changed according to this es, and the change is proportional to the es, and that proportionality actually is introduced by k. This k is actually in kilohertz or megahertz per volt. The unit of k will be some hertz per volt. Usually it is kilohertz or megahertz. So fc has been changed to fc plus or minus k into es by the speed. So the instantaneous frequency of the signal after this frequency modulation can be represented as fi is equal to fc plus k into es. I can write like this, because k is the frequency deviation constant, and the frequency deviation occurs with respect to the amplitude of the signal, so we can write it as fc plus k into es. So which is equal to, I can write it as fc plus k into es cos omega s into t, since es is the es cos omega t. Now if we consider the maximum and minimum, that is fc max occurs at, we know, fc plus k into es, and fc minimum occurs fc at fc minus k into es. So from this one, the delta f will be fc max minus fc minimum divided by 2, which is equal to k into es. So delta f, the frequency variation, will be maximum frequency variation will be delta f is equal to k into es. This is actually delta f max. Now we know that in frequency modulation, the carrier frequency is varied sinusoidally at a signal frequency. The instantaneous deviation in frequency from the carrier is proportional to the instantaneous amplitude of the modulating signal. Thus the instantaneous angular frequency of the frequency modulated wave can be represented as omega I is equal to omega c plus delta omega c into cos omega s into t. Now the total phase angle theta is equal to omega t, where omega is a variable, can be written as theta is equal to integral omega I dt from 0 to t. So this theta is the actual phase angle of the instantaneous value of the frequency modulated wave. So if you represent the frequency modulated wave by some sinusoidal functions, let's say some E is equal to the amplitude, that we are calling it as amplitude of the frequency modulated wave is same as the carrier amplitude, so I can represent it as EC into cos theta. So here theta is the phase angle, where theta is equal to omega t, where omega is the angular frequency of the frequency modulated wave. The we know that the angular frequency of the frequency modulated wave varies with respect to time or with respect to the more precisely speaking, it is the variation of omega I is with respect to the instantaneous values of the amplitude of the signal voltage. So now if we calculate it, we can see that 0 to t omega I is omega c plus delta omega c into cos omega s into t into dt. If we integrate it, we will get the first term is omega c into t plus delta omega c is a constant, take it outside. Cos omega s t is sine omega s into t divided by omega s. So this is theta. So now if you represent the frequency modulated wave, so FM wave, the amplitude, the voltage E is equal to EC cos theta, where theta is omega C into T, plus delta omega C by omega S cos omega, sin omega s into t. Here the quantity delta omega c by omega s, which actually represents the ratio of the change in the variation of the carrier frequency with respect to the signal frequency, is called the modulation index, MI, which is called modulation index. So we can define a new quantity, the modulation index MI, as the ratio of the maximum frequency deviation to the frequency of the modulating signal. That is, this delta omega c by omega s can be represented as 2 pi f delta f divided by 2 pi f s, which is equal to, this is the carrier frequency change, which is equal to fc max minus fc, that is delta f divided by fs, or delta f by fs is called the modulation index. Now if we consider the spectrum of frequency, that is the number of frequency present in the frequency modulated wave, unlike in the amplitude modulated wave we can have three frequencies. One frequency is corresponding to the carrier frequency and the two other frequencies are called the sideband frequencies, the upper sideband frequency and the lower sideband frequency. But in the case of a frequency modulated wave, we can have a number of frequencies, or we can say that there is a frequency spectrum we can obtain in the case of a frequency modulated wave. We are not going to the details of those, how we can see the number of frequencies present in the frequency modulated wave, but we can finally, we are writing the final result of that mathematical analysis here. If we do the mathematical analysis and the frequency spectrum of FM wave, we can see that it will contain the frequencies fc FC plus or minus FS, FC plus or minus 2FS, FC plus or minus 3FS, and so on. So here this FC is the carrier frequency, the FC plus FS, FC plus 2FS, FC plus 3FS, etc. are called upper sideband frequencies. And FC minus FS, FC minus 2FS, FC minus 3FS, etc. are called lower sideband frequencies. So in the case of a frequency modulated wave, we can have a number of frequencies in this frequency modulated wave. That frequencies are FC, FC plus or minus FS, FC plus or minus 2FS, FC plus or minus 3FS, etc. And the important new quantity which actually represents the strength of the frequency modulation is the modulation index, which is given by the ratio of the maximum change in the frequency of the carrier wave to the frequency of the signal wave or modulating signal. The instantaneous value of the voltage of a frequency modulated wave can be represented by the equation E is equal to EC cos omega CT plus delta omega C by omega S sin omega ST. Here you can see that this EC is the amplitude of the carrier wave itself, omega CT represents the phase angle of the carrier wave itself, or omega C is the frequency of the carrier wave, and in addition to this frequency omega C, some another frequency term delta omega C by omega S into sin omega S comes with this voltage of the instantaneous voltage of the frequency modulated wave, or we can say that the frequency of the carrier wave is changed, and this value actually proportional to the sin omega ST, that is the that is sin omega ST. So here it is sin omega ST is actually proportional to the amplitude of the modulating signal. So that's all about the frequency modulation. Now we have to have a comparison of the frequency modulation and amplitude modulation. Here if we compare those amplitude modulation and the frequency modulation, the case of a amplitude modulation, the amplitude of the carrier changes in accordance with the signal amplitude. The case of a frequency modulation, the frequency of the carrier wave changes in accordance with the intensity of the signal. The amplitude modulation, the frequency of the amplitude modulated wave is same as the carrier frequency, but in the case of a frequency modulation, the amplitude of the frequency modulated wave is same as the carrier amplitude. Here the in the case of an amplitude modulation, the modulation factor M cannot be greater than 1. If it is greater than 1, there occurs a distortion. But in the case of a frequency modulation, MI can be greater than 1 also. So these are the basic some of the differences between or comparison between these amplitude modulation and the frequency modulation. Thank you.